The first step of the problem is to check whether the number of persons or are number of equal to number of jobs. So we have five wagons and we have five different stations where the wagons are to be transported. So yes, it is satisfied. Next step, select the smallest number from each row and subtract it from other numbers in the same row. So I can see that in first row minimum number is 5, second row minimum number 6, third row 2, fourth row 9 and fifth row 6. So I will subtract these numbers from their respective rows. After subtracting, I will get the matrix like this. Now next step, again same, we need to have the same operation column wise. So in column, if I see, in first column the minimum number is 1, second column minimum number 0, third column minimum number 0, fourth column 2 and fifth column 3. Now as per the step, I will subtract this number from all the numbers in the respective columns. After doing this, I will get the matrix like this. Now the next and the important step, draw the minimum number of vertical and horizontal lines to cover all zeros in all rows and columns. The word minimum is the most important word here. We have to draw it in minimum number of lines. So we have this matrix. Let us say I am drawing like this, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, all 5 verticals. So this solution is wrong. So let us see this example. In this example, 1, 2, 3, 4, but again I am marking it as wrong, because there might be way where we can cover all the zeros in minimum of lines. It can also be done in less than 4 lines. So let us see another way. Another way to cover the zeros in minimum number of lines is, we can draw one horizontal, vertical and vertical. So you can see from this, all the zeros has been covered by 3 lines only. Hence we can say this is the optimal matrix or the correct matrix. In first column or in the first matrix we saw 5 lines, but it was wrong. In second one there was 4 lines cutting all the zeros, but again that was marked wrong. Why wrong? Because there was a way available in which we can cover the zeros in minimum than 4 lines. So the solution was like this. We can cover all zero in 3 lines. The further steps will remain same. Next step is, are the number of horizontal lines and vertical lines equal to number of rows? So we have seen we can cover zeros in 3 lines only. So we will write, no, it is not equal. L is not equal to N. L is less than N. Then in this case, what to do? We have the procedure. Select the minimum of uncut element. Select the minimum of uncut element from the matrix, subtract it from all the uncut elements and add it at the intersection point. So you can see here, the minimum number from uncut elements is 1. So what I will do, I will subtract this 1 from all uncut elements in the matrix and add it at the intersection points. So what I will get is this matrix. You can see the ones in the blue color are the intersection points. So at the intersection points I have added that 1, and the ones which are in black color, at that point I have subtracted. So step again remains the same. After doing this, again we have to draw and check whether the minimum number of vertical lines and horizontal lines are equal or not. So I will go by this process, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Let us see whether this procedure is correct or not. No, this procedure is also wrong. Why wrong? Because there might be a way in which we can cover these zeros in minimum number of lines than 5 or 4. So let us say another example, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you can see I have covered all the zeros in 4 lines. So this is the correct way of covering all the zeros by minimum number of horizontal and vertical lines. But now again, what happens here that we have covered all the zeros in four lines, but our number of rows and number of columns were five. So this is also not an optimum solution. We have to repeat this step. We have to repeat this step of covering all the zeros unless we get the number of lines is equal to number of rows. So here we again have, yes, number of horizontal and vertical lines are not equal. L is less than n. Select the minimum number of the uncut elements, subtract it from the uncut numbers, and add it at the intersection points. So we can see here the minimum number is, the minimum number from here it is 3. So I will subtract 3 from all uncut elements and add it at the intersection points. Okay. So see here, I have subtracted 3 and subtracted it from the all uncut elements. And again, I will check whether the number of lines are equal to number of rows or columns or not. So here you can see this 5. Now, again, I will check whether this is the correct option of covering all the zeros. So yes, this is the correct option because there is no other option which can cover all zeros in minimum number of lines than 5. Hence, I can now say that this is the optimum solution. You can see another way of cutting the lines or covering the zeros, but there is no other way in which we can cover the zeros in minimum number than 5. Hence, now I can say yes, my step is correct, that my number of lines is equal to number of rows or columns. As we get this, next step will be assignment. So as we got that number of lines are equal to number of columns or rows, next step will be to do the assignment. Now for assignment, I have given you a technique. See where in the row there is a single zero appearing. So first line there are two zeros, I will leave it. Second line two zeros, third line two zeros. Yes, fourth line I am finding out one single zero. So I will assign it by making a box over it. Now, as soon as I make a box or assign the station 2 with wagon 4, the zeros in that particular row or column will be cancelled out because of the assumption that one job can be assigned to one person only. So because of this, I will cancel out all these. Next step, again, we will follow the same procedure whether in a row there is a single zero or not. So starting with the first row, yes, I am finding out a single zero. So I will make a assignment there. After doing the assignment, I have to cancel out all zeros in the particular row or column. So I will cancel out these zeros. Then again, same procedure, but second line there are two zeros. Let it be. Third line, again, I am finding out single zero. So I will assign it and cancel out other zeros in the same row or column. Then last, there are only two zeros remaining and both are single zeros. So I will assign it like this. This I can say that all assignments are made and my solution is optimum because five assignments are assigned to various five categories. So assignments are 1 with 1, 2 with 3, 3 with 4, 4 with 2, and 5 with 5. Now, in the question, it was also asked to find out what is the minimum mileage. So for minimum mileage, you have to check the cost metrics which were given in the question. So as we have assigned 1 to 1, the cost associated with that or the mileage, the minimum mileage for 1 to 1 was 10. So 10, 6, 4, 9 and 10. This gives me answer as the minimum mileage between assigning this wagons to various stations will be 39. So no other option than this will give you the answer equal to 39 or less than 39. This completes the solution. Unmute yourself and ask the questions if any. So should I proceed to the next problem if there is no doubt? So let us now first see what are the special cases in assignment problem. So first case, first special case is unbalanced assignment problem. Unbalanced assignment problem means if the first step is invalid, that means if number of rows will not be equal to number of columns. Second is maximization problem. Again, till now what we have covered was the minimum, find minimum cost, find minimum time, find minimum mileage, etc. Now, what if the question is find the maximum profit, find what is the maximum sales, etc. So this is the case of maximization problem. Third step, restricted assignment problem. Restricted assignment problem means in question it will be specified that this job can't be assigned to this person. For example, let us say a lathe machine operator. He is very much experienced in operating lathe. He can do turning, he can do boring, etc., etc. But this same person can't be assigned to a CNC machine which needs some codings. So I will what I will do in front of him, his name, I will mark a dash. That means CNC can't be assigned to this operator. The last case of special cases is alternate optimum solution. This all cases will be more clear when we solve the problem. So first I will start with unbalanced assignment problem. The question says a departmental head has 4 subordinates and 3 tasks to be done. Estimated time for the task to take to perform is given in the matrix below. How should the task be allotted so as to minimize the total man hours? Now in the question you can see there are 3 jobs to be assigned, A, B, C, but there are 4 mans available, M1, M2, M3 and M4. So as number of rows is not equal to number of columns, this is the case of unbalanced assignment problem. So now let us see how to tackle this case. As I said, the steps will not change. Step 1, check whether the number of persons are equal to number of jobs. So here it will be a wrong. Why wrong? Because the number of jobs are 3 and number of mans are 4. Now in this case what to do? So step 1b is insert a dummy row or column. Now because we are adding a dummy row, the cost associated with it will be 0. See here, I have done it. Dekho, hamare paas kya tha? There were 4 mans, M1, M2, M3 and M4. But job the A, B, C. Job mein mujhe kam pad raha tha. So what I have done? I have created one dummy job. Okay? I have created one dummy job. But the cost associated with it, I have kept it 0. Because there is no actual job which is there that can be assigned. This is just done to make the number of rows equal to number of columns. Now what happened? Now our number of rows has become equal to number of columns. So on the screen I have kept the solution till step 4 after doing row and column operations. If anyone has doubt, please ask. I again repeat, the steps are exactly same. Only first step has been changed where I have inserted a dummy row or column. Yes. The assignment was A to M2, B to M1, C to M3, and D or M4 to dummy. What this indicates, or what we can conclude from this? The conclusion from this is the man M4 will be sitting idle. He will not have any job to do. Because there were only 3 jobs, A, B, C. A job will be done by worker 2 or man 2. B job will be done by worker or man 1. And C job will be done by man 3. Hence, the fourth man who is available, which he will be idle. He will be not doing any work. So, any doubts in this problem to anyone?
Sir.
If someone has problem. Yeah.
Sir, agar job zyada rahe aur man kam rahega to.
Man kam rahega to man mein hum log dummy bana denge.
एक डमी मैन में बनाना
बराबर जहां पर वेयर एवर यू फाइंड शॉर्टेज यू ऐड अ डमी सपोज देयर आर 5 जॉब्स एंड 3 मेंस सो वी विल ऐड 2 डमी मेन
एनी अदर सर डमी कांसेप्ट में जीरो आएगा क्या
डमी यस डमी में सब जीरो इसलिए आता है द कांसेप्ट बिहाइंड इज बिकॉज़ इट इज अ डमी देयर विल बी नो कॉस्ट एसोसिएटेड जब चीज है ही नहीं तो उसका कॉस्ट कैसे होगा इसलिए सभी कॉस्ट जीरो रहेंगे एनी अदर डाउट इन सॉल्विंग सॉल्व द फॉलोइंग असाइनमेंट प्रॉब्लम ₹50 lakhs इज टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ रिपेयर्स First, find the best way of assigning the repair work to contractors. if it is necessary to seek supplementary grants, then what should be the amount? And third is, which of the five contractors will be unsuccessful in the bid? From here only, or from the question given itself, we can determine that number of rows are not equal to number of columns. You can see the contractors are five. There are five contractors who are bidding, and the roads available for repairs are only four: R1, R2, R3, and R4. So we will proceed to our step. First step, check whether the number of persons are equal to number of rows. So in this case, we have to insert a dummy row or column. Here the contractors are five, but number of roads available are four. So hum log kahan par add karenge? Ek dummy column add karenge as road five. That will be a dummy row like this. So now there are five contractors and there are five roads available. Hence, I will proceed further to the next step. Take 5 minutes to solve the question. Till then, any doubts you can ask me. Follow exactly same steps. So you can see on the screen, in first step, I am getting the zeros covered by only four lines. So this is not the optimum solution. We can't proceed for assignment. So here what we need to do, we have to select the smallest number, that is one, subtract it from uncut elements and add it at the intersection points. It's the same process which we were following previously. Think that in one iteration also you will not get the answer. You will have to perform two iterations. So in third step, you will get the minimum number of lines as 5. So after doing two steps or two iterations, I will get number of lines equal to number of rows. Okay. Now just look at the last step. Till this step, anyone can do. The last step which I want to show, there is something different in this question. Now, after doing the initial steps, that is till number of rows equal to number of columns equal to number of lines, after that we proceed to the assignment part. So for assignment, as per the hint, you have to check a single zero in the row or column. So in first row, two zeros are there. In second row, two zeros. In third row, two zeros. Fourth row also two zero. And fifth row also two zeros. So there is no row in which I am finding out a single zero to be assigned. No problem. Now we will go column wise. Row wise agar nahi mil raha hai, go column wise. So first column. First column, again there are two zeros. Yes. Second column, I am finding out only one single zero. So I will assign it. And after assigning, I have to cross all the zeros in that particular row or column. So it will be crossed. Now, again, I will see whether there is any single zero or not. Okay, so we have assigned C4 with R2. I have checked the calculation. I think it is correct. So if I am not able to get a single zero, now the case comes where we can select any arbitrary zero as per our wish. Now let us say I am selecting C2 and R1 as my assignment. Okay, so if I select C2 with R1, all the other zeros in the same row or column will be cancelled out. Now you can see again in C3 there is only single zero, so that will be assigned. Then all zeros in the same row or column will be cancelled. Then C5 again only single zero remains, so single zero will be assigned, and all the zeros in row and column will be cancelled. And now only thing remains C1 with R3. So this I can say, as all assignments are made, solution is optimum. But now someone will ask me, sir, aapne C2 or R1 ko consider kiya. What if I have considered any other case? No problem, you can consider, you will get the same optimum answer. So this is also a case of multiple optimum solutions. The answer finally you will get will be same. So answer will be, the question asked were, find the best way of assigning the repair work. So we have already made the assignments. If it is necessary to seek supplementary grants, what should be the amount? So if you calculate the total minimum cost as per the assignment which we have done, it will come out to be 56 lakhs. The minimum cost will be 56 lakhs. Now the government has already given us 50 lakhs for repair. Now, how much additional supplementary grants we will require? It will be 56 minus 50, that will be 6 lakhs. And third question was, which of the 5 contractors will be unsuccessful in the bid? So one which will be assigned to dummy road will be unsuccessful. So as per our calculations, C3 will be unsuccessful as C3 was assigned to R5, which was dummy. This completes the problem. So this problem has two special cases. First special case was the number of rows was not equal to number of columns. And second special case was it has multiple optimum solutions. Now, if anyone has doubt, please ask and then we will leave.
Sir, agar ye क्या बोलते हैं हम लोग ऐसे आर्बिट्री जीरोस कोई भी लेना है तो उससे कॉस्ट पे इफेक्ट नहीं पड़ेगा?
नहीं पड़ेगा
लास्ट में ऑप्टिमल से ज्यादा मिल गया तो
नहीं आएगा ना. देखो हमारा हम लोग जीरो बनाते क्यों है, मैं पहले लेक्चर में बोला था जीरो बनाने का मकसद क्या है
भाई, वो मिनिमम हो जाए,
वो मिनिमम हो जाए और उससे दूसरे का रिलेटिव कॉस्ट पता चले क्या अगर इसका जीरो है तो उसका क्या होगा. बराबर अगर हम ये इसको असाइन नहीं करते दूसरे को असाइन कर दिए तो उनको कितना एक्स्ट्रा देना पड़ेगा. बट अभी अगर सभी जीरो है तो इसको असाइन करो या उसको असाइन करो कोई एक्स्ट्रा देने की जरूरत नहीं है.
ओके सर,
इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क. द रिव्यू इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम रिमेन्स सेम. जस्ट एट इनिशियल फेज व्हाट वी हैव लर्न टुडे इज इफ इट इज less in row we will add a dummy row, if it is less in numbers in column we will add a dummy column, and if there are more than one zero in a row or column which can't be assigned then we will do assignment arbitrarily, but then too the final answer will come as same. This was the learning of today's lecture.